हेलो, अ वार्म वेलकम टू यू फ्रॉम SGT यूनिवर्सिटी. आई एम गीतांजलि सोलंकी, फैकल्टी ऑफ फैशन एंड डिज़ाइन. सो टुडे वी विल बी लर्निंग अबाउट पैटर्न मेकिंग टूल्स एंड देयर इक्विपमेंट्स.
क्रिएटिंग स्विंग पैटर्न कैन नॉट थिंक विदाउट पैटर्न मेकिंग टूल्स. यू विल नीड द राइट पैटर्न मेकिंग टूल्स टू मेक परफेक्ट क्लोदिंग और स्विंग पैटर्न्स. द पैटर्न मेकर शुड नो अबाउट ऑल पैटर्न मेकिंग टूल्स यूजेस एंड फंक्शन. In this video, I have discussed all the pattern making tools with functions. Let's take a look about pattern making devices. So we have measuring devices, drafting devices, marking devices, cutting devices, swing devices, finishing or pressing devices. We can start with measuring devices. Measuring tools are the most essential thing in pattern making. The key to success in garment construction lies in taking accurate measurements of the subject and by using the appropriate tools for pattern making. This picture shows you the different type of measuring device using in pattern making. So, in measuring device, we have measuring tape, CPG measuring tape, leg measuring tape, measuring stand and ruler. Measuring tape is the indensible for taking body measurement. It is 152 cm or 60 inches long with measurements on both sides. CPG measuring tape, this is used for taking measurement for a cot. Leg measuring tape, it is used for measuring the inner part of the leg. Measuring stand. This stand is used to measure long garments such as long overcoat, frocks or gowns, as well as the flare of the garment. Ruler. It is the best device for taking long straight measurement. It is mostly used for checking grain line and marking hems. Then we can talk about drafting device. Drafting equipment is used for making paper pattern. This is the second stage of pattern making. Using the measurements taken, the drafting is carried out according to the design of a garment. This is the picture of some drafting devices. In drafting device, we can talk about L scale, leg shaper, tailor's art curve, French curve, compass, drafting table, Milton cloth, brush, brown paper, pencil, rubber, red and blue pencils. Now we can talk about marking devices. Marking devices are used for transferring the details of the paper draft to the fabric. This picture shows you some marking devices. This is the another one picture shows you some marking devices. In marking devices, we have tailor chalk. It is made up of china clay and is available in different colors. It is used for marking the paper patterns on the clothes. Then we have chalk in pencil form. This is used like a pencil and is ideal for marking the thin accurate lines. This is used for marking pleats, dart and button holes. Tracing wheel, it is used for transferring the pattern markings on fabrics. Dressmakers, carbon paper. Carbon papers are mostly used for transferring patterns. Then we have cutting devices. Cutting devices or equipment should be selected and used with maximum accuracy. A slight change in cut results in huge fitting problems. We have the following cutting devices: cutting table and cutting board, shears, scissors, paper cutting scissor, pinking shears, trimming scissors, buttonhole scissors. In this picture, we have the different type of cutting tools. Then we have swing devices. Swing can be carried out either manual or by machines. These are the following tools for swings. This is the another one pictures of swing devices. In swing devices, we can use needles, screw needles or draw needle, pins, pin cushions, needle threader, seam ripper, thimble. In pattern making, finishing or pressing is the most important devices. In this device, we include iron, ironing board, sleeve board. These are some following pressing devices. This picture shows you some finishing devices.
Pattern making is an art of paper cutting, slashing and spreading method. So it is a blueprint of the fabric on the basis which fabric is cut. So with the help of tools and terminologies, we can construct our own pattern of our own design.
Now we can talk about terminologies of pattern making. We have the following objectives in pattern making. Number one, to know the principle of pattern making. Number two, to understand the drafting and the flat pattern techniques. To comprehend the draping method of pattern making. To understand methods of taking body measurements for various garments. The garment construction involves study and analysis of the garment to be made in terms of that of measurements, the drafting of the pattern, the cutting of the garment according to the pattern, the joining of the different parts, the fitting and necessary alterations, the sewing and finishing of the garment, the applications of trimming if these are used, the pressing methods. Pattern making is a highly skilled technique which calls for technical ability, sensitivity for design interpretations, and a practical understanding of garment construction. Pattern making is a bridge functions between design and production. Three methods of preparing patterns. Number one, drafting. Number two, flat pattern making techniques. And third one is draping fabric on a model or the person concerned. Let's begin with the first method, that is drafting. This video shows you the basic bodice drafting. We required the 7 body measurement for our basic bodice block. All the horizontal line should be measured from side seam to side seam. Side line measured from under your arm down to your waist. AB is the full front length of the bodice. AC is the half of across chest plus 3/8 of an inch. Then CD is 1.5 inch. DE is the shoulder length. And BF is the center front length. This line should be drawn as an approximately 45 degree angle. Make sure the neckline curve touches point G. Now HI is half front bust plus half inch. FJ is half FH. JK is half across chest. Then HL is half across chest. Make LM is 1 inch at a 45 angle. This video shows you step-by-step construction of basic bodice block. With the help of these steps, we can construct the basic bodice block drafting. A basic bodice block is a great starting point for most patterns involving your top half. It can be used to make tops and dresses, and paired with a sleeve block can be used to make shirts, blazers, jackets and coats. Many pattern involves from this block, so if you are ready to start making your own patterns, then a bodice block to your specific measurements is a great place to start. Drafting is the process of creating a pattern by taking measurements from a person, form, or model in order to then create a foundation, which is a pattern used as the basic for the design.
So, in this lecture, we covered the different types of tools and terminologies used in pattern making. And in our next lecture, we will discuss about anthropometric measurement in pattern making. Till then, keep learning, keep growing. See you next time.